Hello students, I am Dr. Tanmay Vishwas. I welcome you all in my channel Chemistry and History of Molecules. So today we will discuss a very short topic, that is epoxidation of alpha-beta-unsaturated carbonyl compound. In previous lecture I have described about the epoxidation of simple alkene into simple alkene, but there is a problem of epoxidation of alpha-beta-unsaturated carbonyl compound using m-CPBA. So we will discuss how to, what is the problem and how to overcome this problem. Okay. So if we follow the general technique, that is this alpha-beta-unsaturated carbonyl compound, plus if we take par acid like m-CPBA, metachloroparbenzoic acid, this, if we do this in DCM, so what could be the product? Or in presence of some insoluble base, it is better to write insoluble base. So actually this reaction does not happen. Why? Because actually this reaction proceeds by where this double bond act as nucleophile. Nucleophile, what do I mean? Electron rich. This double bond should be electron rich. But if you look at this, because of the resonance, means this double bond, the electron density of this double bond is partially delocalized on this carbonyl. So it is not electron rich. That's why this reaction cannot happen. So what is the solution? So in case of any problem, majority of cases, the problem itself is the solution. Why? This double bond is not electron rich. This is not electrophilic. But here nucleophilic attack possible. So this is actually electron deficient. So it can do electrophilic attack, but it can undergo nucleophilic attack. And for that reason, what could be the best option? Best option is hydrogen peroxide and alkene. By the way, there are some other disadvantages also. For example, under some circumstances, you may be able to achieve the final product. Let's consider this. Logical. But in associate with this, there are few side reactions. What a side reaction? See, this is a ketone. And in presence of par acid, what it can convert? It can convert into corresponding ester. For example, here, when. Or the other one also, or the other one, means this vinyl migration. So it may form ester formation possible, but so there is a problem using this method. So how this problem could be avoided? This problem could be avoided using hydrogen peroxide and alkene. Why? Because you know the hydrogen peroxide, if you compare the corresponding hydrogen peroxide versus hydroxide, the hydrogen peroxide is more nucleophilic, less basic. Okay, because of the alpha effect. Alpha effect means the lone pair repulsion. This oxygen, this lone pair repulsion. This is hydrogen, this is hydrogen. So this is called alpha effect. So because of this alpha effect, this is more nucleophilic but less basic. So what happens? In presence of alkali, it generates this hydroperoxide anion. Means three lone pair. So what happens? This, since it's a good nucleophile, so it is a nucleophile, it acts as a nucleophile. So this attacks this carbon because it is electron deficient electrophilic, so it attacks and opens. So what is consequence? Consequence is this is O minus in hydrogen OH. Now always keep it in mind that this bond is weak. This oxygen-oxygen bond is weak, higher in energy, not stable. So that's why attack on this bond means attack on the sigma star of this bond possible. Sigma star attack is possible. So what happens in this case? In this case, the negative charge comes back here, and this, I should write it properly. So you may consider it attacks, and this attacks here eclipse. Why? Because this oxygen-oxygen bond is weaker. So what is the consequence? The consequence is this. So whatever we wanted to get, we have achieved. So this is the method. Means one problem can be a solution or can be a new way to develop some other methodology. So simplest reagent, hydrogen peroxide, alkali is enough. By the way, one important information, how peroxy acids are prepared? Peroxy acids are prepared from, for example, M.CPBA. This is prepared from this acid chloride plus sodium hydroxide plus hydrogen peroxide. Okay, better to say what is the active reagent? Active reagent is O minus, which attacks, it comes open this. So in this way, these peroxy acids are prepared. Means that this hydrogen peroxide, anyway, this reagent combination is used to prepare this peroxy acid, which is then used for a reagent for epoxidation. So indirectly, what you are getting here is a back prime chemical combination to do this reaction. So this is the beauty of this reaction. Okay. Okay. So this is the end of this discussion. So what you have learned today? Why epoxidation of alpha-beta-unsaturated carbonyl compound could not be achieved using traditional epoxidation method, that is peroxide acids. Second point, how to get using sodium hydroxide and hydrogen peroxide. And additional benefit is that peroxy acids are prepared from this combination. So we are using a core reagent. So that is a beneficial for this method, overall mechanism. So thank you everyone. Thanks for your patience. So if you really like my teaching, please help me to grow my channel. First of all, subscribe my channel Chemistry the Mystery of Molecule, and please press the bell icon to get the notification of every single video I upload. Secondly, I request you please share this video among your friends such that many people could be benefited from my effort, and it will be satisfactory point for me as well as it will indirectly help my channel to grow. And most importantly, please may like, comment, and if you think that some modification, rectification, improvement essential, please feel free to mention in the comment box. I request you, I need some support from you in order to upload videos on a regular basis. So please, you help from your side, I'll try my best. So thank you again, thank you everyone, see you in my next video. God bless you.